the swap, then typically what kind of cash flows are we looking at between the two parties? Once you are comfortable with basics, then we will learn the pricing part of it, that how do you price a currency swap. And once you're comfortable with pricing, then in the last leg, we will go towards the valuation, which is going to be fun, but it is going to require a lot of sub-steps to do the valuation. All right, so let's start with basics. We know that every swap has a notional principle, correct? So in this instance, I'm going to define notional principle as, let us say, $100 million. Now, how currency swap is different than most of the other swaps is that in currency swap, notional principle generally, in most of the cases, notional principle is exchanged. So right now I'm defining that in the US dollars, so notional principle 100 million. And let us say we will keep numbers really simple, so let's say it's a 4-year swap. The other currency involved, let's keep it at Australian dollars. Okay, so we'll set up exchange rate as, let me make up something randomly, 1.4000 Australian dollars for one US dollar. Then again, in this instance, both the parties are going to be paying fixed. So we typically say it is a fixed to fixed swap, which means one party will pay fixed rate, the other party will also pay fixed rate. But there could be total 4 varieties in a currency swap. We can have fixed to fixed, we can have fixed to floating, we can have floating to floating, and we can have floating to fixed. That means one leg of the swap, one leg means one side, it can either have a fixed rate or floating rate. The other side, same story, and therefore we can have 4 possible combination. The valuation principle more or less is going to be same. Okay, so once you learn 1 or 2 varieties, you should be able to extrapolate, apply them everywhere else. Right now we're doing a very simple fixed to fixed type of situation. The fixed rate on US dollars, let us say, is 4%. And fixed rate on Australian dollars is, let us say, 6.5%. Okay, so we will define 2 parties. Let's call party A. Party A is going to be, it is going to pay in USD. Or let me define it this way. It is going to receive $100 million from party B, and that means it will have to pay upfront in Australian dollars. Party B is going to receive Australian dollars upfront. These are initial payments, and it is going to pay in US dollar. So now what I want you to do is break down your analysis into 3 parts. The first part, you figure out what would be the cash flows of the swap at inception. That means at initiation, when you're starting signing the agreement, what cash flows are we going to have? What cash flows are you going to have during those 4 years on an annual basis? And what cash flows are you going to have on termination? So we are going to break down the transaction into 3 parts. Okay, so I'm going to give you maybe a minute, see if you can figure that part out. Figure out which party is going to pay what at inception, termination, and during the life of the swap. Are you done? Okay, let me do it. Let's see how this works on inception. So this is party A, party B. We know that in currency swap, typically notional principal is exchanged. So A is going to pay some amount to B, and B is going to pay something in return to A. Let's see how much. So A is going to receive $100 million. Right? So here we are going to say A will receive $100 million. And in turn, A will have to pay what? Australian dollars. At what rate? So depending on the exchange rate at the inception, which is how much? 1.40. So if I want to convert $100 million at 1.40 exchange rate, how much will that become? 140. So here the payment that we will have to make is Australian dollars 140 million. This is what you do at the beginning of the swap, initiation or inception. Is that okay? Now what happens at termination? So at termination, we have a classic reversal of cash flow. Whatever you received at the beginning, that you have to pay back. That's simple. So again, I'm making the same arrows here, but we just have to invert the cash flow. So A received $100 million. So now A will have to pay $100 million. Are you following this? At the beginning, A received $100 million. So now A will have to pay back those $100 million. And B received 140 million Australian dollars. So B will have to pay what? 140 million Australian dollars. Now, there's something very interesting here. This termination is going to happen after how many years? 4 years. I did not even tell you what was the exchange rate that day. Doesn't matter. Once the entire stream of cash flows of a swap is determined based on what was the exchange rate at initiation, so we don't worry about the exchange rate. I have paid 100, I'm going to receive 100. I have received 140, I will have to pay 140. That's it. So these are your cash flows at inception, termination. Now, during 4 years, typically when you look at any other swap, we do something called as netting. Have you heard of netting? Netting is like this. I owe you 10,000, you owe me 12,000. So net the difference and you just pay me 2,000, correct? But in a currency swap, netting doesn't happen because two stream of payments are happening in two different currencies. So every year, and this is going to happen for 4 years, so there are going to be four payments like this. A will pay something to B. It will pay what? It will pay whatever it has received. It will pay interest on whatever currency it has received at inception. So you tell me, A received what? 100 million US dollars. And what is the fixed rate on USD? 4%. So how much A will have to pay every year? 4 million US dollars. And let's think from B perspective. What did B receive at inception? 140 million Australian dollars. And if it has received 140 million Australian dollars, it will have to pay interest on that. How much? 6.5%. Let's do it quickly. Tell me how much. 9.1. So it will have to pay 9.1 million Australian dollars to A. That is how the swap cash flows are going to operate during the life of the swap. Are you okay with this? Now, there are a variety of reasons why a currency swap might be useful. One simple reason could be like this. Just think of A for the timing. Let us say that A happens to be an Australian. Okay, don't write, just focus for a minute. A is Australian, but A is willing to set up a business in the US. So to set up a business, A is going to need capital. It is going to need US dollars. But A being a foreigner company or foreign company, when it goes to the US, the borrowing cost is going to be expensive. What instead it can do is it can borrow locally. So A is now, A can go to the bank and it can borrow how much? 140 million Australian dollars. Will borrowing cost be relatively advantageous because you are borrowing in the home country? And then it can enter into a swap with B. And whatever amount it borrowed from the bank, it can just give even the swap. And then it can receive what? US dollars. Then A is going to do business in which country now? US. So all the operating cash flows are going to come in which currency? US dollar. So look at in which currency A is making payment every year? US dollar. Makes sense, right? That you're doing business for 4 years, so every year you keep on making payment in US dollar. And then at the termination, maybe you're shutting down the business. Let's say it's a small project. So at the termination, you sell the business. When you sell your business in the US, what currency do you get? US dollar. So you pay those US dollars, you get your Australian dollars back. You get that 140 back, you go to the bank, correct? And you pay off the interest. So that you pay off the principal. So that way, it is going to meet requirement of both the parties. Are you following the intuition? Okay, let's practice a little more. Let me give you a set of cash flows. Let's see if you can handle this. Notional principal, again, on one leg, 100 million US dollars. But this time we'll do it with rupees. So we'll say rupee for US dollar exchange rate. Indian rupee for US dollar exchange rate, let's say 70. And again, we will make it a 3-year swap. And we will make it USD fixed and INR floating, Indian rupee floating. Now, based on this information, what you guys need to figure out is the cash flows at initiation, during the life of the swap, and cash flows at termination. Initiation during those 3 years, and what would be the cash flow for at termination? USD rate, I'll have to give you, let's say that's 4%. So again, keep one party A. Let me define those parties for you. Let's say A. A is going to receive $100 million. Okay, and then you define party B on the other side. So A is going to receive $100 million. And in turn, A will have to pay what? 100 into 70, how much? 7,000 rupees. Million. So we'll keep it in million, it'll be easier. Then termination is simple. If you know inception, you know termination. What you simply need to do is reverse the cash flows. So A received $100 million, it will have to pay $100 million. And B received 7,000 million rupees, so B will have to pay 7,000 million rupees. Now, during those 3 years, there will be three payments that would be exchanged. What will A pay? You help me with this. A received $100 million, So it has to make payment on which currency? US dollars. At what rate? 4%. So every year it will have to pay $4 million. And B will have to pay based on a floating rate, a reference rate. There should be some reference or benchmark there, some floating rate, which we do not know at this moment. Correct? So whatever is the floating rate, depending on how interest rate curve evolve in India in future, the payments will change. So now I'm going to give you the payment structure. Let us say the interest rate evolves like this. Time 0, time 1, time 2, time 3. At time 0, that means at the time of signing the agreement, let's say the rate was 10%, some reference rate in India. At time 1, it became 8%. Time 2, I'm intentionally exaggerating numbers here, 11%. Time 3, it became 13%. So now based on this, you figure out the payment that is to be made on Indian rupees by B to A. We know the USD payment, you figure out the Indian rupee payments now for 3 years, year 1, year 2, year 3. Got it? So first payment on a timeline, it's going to happen at time 0, time 1. Time 1, right? So this is your cash flow 1 here. This would be your cash flow 2. And this would be your cash flow 3. So when you have to make payment of cash flow 1, are you going to use 8% or 10%? So that's correct. The payment in the first payment would be 10%, because we have to see what rate was applicable in this window. So 10% is applicable here, whereas 8% would be applicable for second year, right? So 10%, and what is the notional principal? 7,000. So how much is that going to be? So 700 million rupees. Second, so here payment we did but 10. Here we'll have to do it with 8. So how much would that be? 560 million rupees. And how about the last one? That would be 770 million rupees. How many of you got this right? That's great. Okay with this? All right. So now, once you're okay with basics, let's start doing slightly advanced stuff. Let's start doing currency swap pricing. Now, to do currency swap pricing, there is one simple rule we have to follow. We have to ensure that value at inception or initiation has to be zero. The same logic. Because just by signing the agreement, you cannot have a profit or loss. Which means at time zero, value of both the legs has to be equal. Correct? Because one of them is asset, one of them is liability. So the total valuation will become zero. Now, how do you ensure that? So here's your first example. Again, I'm using simplified numbers here. We'll go back to USD and Australian dollar example. This is $100 million. And exchange rate is 1.40 AUD for USD. And then the Australian dollar notional principal will become 140. Million. Now let us say this is the interest rate curve in the US. So US rates 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll use simple spot rates here, annual compounding. 2%, 3%, 3.5, 4%. These are the Australian dollar or AUD rates, the interest rates there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 7.2, 8%. Now, we know that from any party's perspective, when they're entering into a swap, essentially they're buying two bonds, but this time on two different currencies. One bond is of US dollar, the other bond is of Australian dollar. One bond is going to be an asset, other bond is going to be a liability. If we ensure that the value of both the bonds is exactly same, then automatically value of swap becomes zero. And if you want to keep value of both the bonds same, one easy way of doing it is make both the bonds the par bonds. So if I can somehow figure out a par rate based on this transaction and a par rate based on these transactions, then what will happen? We know that if I find out a par rate, then market value of this bond will become how much? $100 million. And market value of this bond will become how much? 140 million Australian dollars. But 140 million Australian dollars today is same as 100 million US dollars. One of them would be asset, one of them would be liability. Net net valuation would be zero. Which means the same valuation principle that we applied for interest rate swaps, we apply the same logic for currency swaps. What we simply need to do here is figure out the par rate. So do it fast. Do you guys know the formula? What we need to do is we calculate discount factors, and this is the formula we use. 1 minus Z4 or Z4 divided by Z1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. Start. Use annual compounding. We are not using LIBORs yet. We'll do an example on those lines as well. Right now, simply use annual compounding. Come on, guys, is it done? Pick up some speed. One of these two, I'm going to do this along with you. Which one should we do together? Let's do the Australian dollar part together, just for practice, okay? So we'll have to calculate four discount factors and plug them into this formula. Let's do it together. 1 divided by 1.06, that's your Z1 here. 1 divided by 1.06. Put that into first memory slot of your calculator. Then 1 divided by 1.07 x square equal to second memory slot. 1 divided by 1.072 raised to 3. So the way, one way of doing it on the calculator is you can say 1 divided by 1.072 x square and then divide that with 1.072 one more time. Equal to STO 3, and 1 divided by 1.08 raised to 4. So you can simply say 1 divided by 1.08 x square twice, STO 4. Once you have these four numbers, I'm guessing you have them now, 1 minus RCL 4 divided by bracket open RCL 1 plus RCL 2 plus RCL 3 plus RCL 4 bracket close equal to, and that should get you the par rate. So give me the this one first. How much is 7.87 percentage? Is this correct? And how about this one? 3.94. So what it means? It means if there is a bond in US dollar currency, and if that bond has a coupon of 3.94 percentage, then looking at the current spot curve structure, the valuation of the bond is going to be how much? The face value, correct? So we'll say $100 million in this instance. In the second scenario, if there's a bond in Australian dollar currency, which has a face value of 140 million, and if it has a coupon of 7.87, then market value of that Australian dollar bond would be how much? 140 million Australian dollars, which means in US dollar, equivalent price would be $100 million. And that means one asset, one liability valuation would be same, and therefore value of the swap will become zero. Got the intuition? So the pricing part is really simple. You price a currency swap more or less the same way how you priced an interest rate swap. Is that okay? Now let's start with the real fun part of this, which is the valuation. This part you're going to enjoy. The first one, do you want it easy or difficult? So I'll try to save us some work. I'll keep the same US interest rates and Australian interest rates. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2%, 3%, 3.5 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 6, 7, 7.2 and 8%. USD notional principle, 100 million. Spot exchange rate, 1.4000 AUD for USD. It's a annual settlement or annual reset swap. The total maturity is of 4 years. Now, first part of the question is price both the legs of the swap, which you guys have already done, which is simple. Now, the second part of the question, let us say after 0.7 years, right? So you have signed the swap and 0.7 years have passed. The revised term structure looks like this. Term structure means how interest rate structure looks like. So let us say in the USD interest rate looks like this. So we have a 0.3 rate. We have 1.3. We have 2.3. We have 3.3. Let us say 4%, 5%. I'm exaggerating the numbers here. 6%, 7%. Australian term structure looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4%, 4.2%. I cannot have 1 point. Wait a minute. 0.3, 1.3, 2.3, 3.3. 4.7%, 5.1%. Now the exchange rate today has also changed. And now the exchange rate has become 1.2105 Australian dollars for USD. 1.2105 Australian dollars for USD. We are doing valuation from a perspective. It's a fixed to fixed swap. And we want to value the swap from perspective of someone who is receiving Australian dollars and is paying US dollars. And what I want you to do is, I want you to give me answer in Australian dollar currency. Now this is fun. Now on the face of it looks like really fancy, but it's not. Okay, so for this question, what I'm going to do is I'm going to break down all the steps into small parts. I'm not going to solve it. I'm just going to tell you how to do it, and then I want you to make an attempt. So let's think from this person perspective. What he needs to do is he's going to receive Australian dollar fixed rate, and he's going to pay US dollar fixed or floating? Fixed. So this is equivalent to, and think of it, this is equivalent to being long on Australian dollar fixed coupon bond. Yes or no? Because he's going to receive Australian dollars. So it's equivalent to Australian dollar long position on Australian dollar fixed coupon bond. What is the coupon rate? We've already calculated. Tell me what was the price. 3.94% here. 7.87 here. So Australian dollar bond coupon rate is 7.87%. In a timeline perspective, you are at 0.7. Bond valuation is really simple. You learned this when you were in the school. How do you do it? Value for bond is present value of all the future cash flow. What cash flows do we have now? Do we have four coupons and we have face value? Do you know the coupon rate? Do you know the face value? The only thing you need now is interest rate, because first cash flow is not coming in 1 year. It is coming in 0.3 years. So you need to have a rate for 0.3 years of Australian dollars. Do you have it? Yes. So but with that logic, you should be able to value a long Australian dollar fixed coupon bond. And since he has to pay, he has to have a short position in USD fixed or floating. Again, fixed coupon bond. Agree? What is the coupon rate on this bond? 3.94%. Again, you have the coupon rate, you have the face value. Do you have the interest rates? Yes. So then value both the bonds in respective currency. This is your step number one. Then in step number two, convert USD bond. Is that your asset or liability? Short means liability, long means asset. So convert USD bond to Australian dollars at current exchange rate. This is where people get tricked. Since I'm doing valuation today, today is what? Time 0.7. So the conversion has to happen at current exchange rate. So which means when you do the conversion, are you going to use 1.40 or 1.21? 1.21. And then what happens is, once you've done this in step number three, you have an asset. Asset is AUD bond, correct, with this coupon. And you have a liability, which is USD bond converted to, tell me, converted to Australian dollar. You take the difference of the two. That's it, job done. That's going to be the value of your swap. Are you following what's happening here? Yes, no. Give it a try. I'll wait for maybe 5 to 7 minutes, and then we will solve this question together. are really simple. Step number one, value the USD bond. You have the cash flows, you have the rates. Value the Australian dollar bond. Convert, compare, take the difference, job done. When both the sides are fixed, it's substantially easier to handle the question. Yes, profit or loss? Profit, how much? Okay, I'm getting different answers. Let's see. How about you, Ronnie? What's your answer? 28 Australian dollars. No, convert them to Australian dollars. No, we want profit in Australian dollars. How much? 44.8 Australian dollars, 45.41. Okay, Sanjeev, what's your answer? 37 Australian dollars. Okay, 34. Gagan, Crystal, how much? 33. How about you? What's your answer? 45. 57. Wow. Ria. Vedang. All right, let's do it together. It's really simple. I don't know why you guys are getting different answers. All right, let's value the USD bond first. Valuation of the USD bond. See, we are using bond analogy to value the swap. Again, I'm repeating it. A swap is a portfolio of bonds. On one side you have long position, on the other side you have short position. So I'm using the same logic. It's just that in this instance, we have two different currencies. So since you are paying USD, this valuation of USD bond, is this asset or liability? It's a liability. Now, what are the characteristics of this bond? So we keep the face value equal to notional principal. How much? $100 million. And coupon rate equal to price of the swap, which is 3.94%. So if I build a timeline, it is going to look like this. Time 0, time 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, today I am at year 0.7, which means today I am here. If this is 0.7, this is today. What are the cash flows are we looking at? So first we will receive 4 coupons, 100 into 3.94%. How much is that? 3.94. All of them in million dollars. So 3.94, 3.94, and 3.94. And at the end of year 4, we will also receive 100. Now the first cash flow we need to discount backwards for this interval from 3.94 to 0.7. We just have to take 0.3 years backwards. Okay, so I'm going to use a usual discounting formula. 3.94 divided by, what is the rate for 0.3 years? 4%. So 1.04 raised to 0.3 plus the second cash flow, 3.94 divided by. Now this we need to discount for how many years? 1.3 years. So 1.3 years, do we have the rate? Yes. So 1.05 raised to 1.3. Then again, 3.94 divided by 1.06 raised to 2.3. And finally, 103.94 divided by 1.07 raised to 3.3. And then you simply discount the cash flows, add them up. That's the valuation of your bond in US dollars, in millions. How much is that? 94.2. Okay, approximately 94.20. Fine, 1.7. Happy now? Do you want to do the valuation together? In the last class, I did show you a faster way to do the valuation. I told you this 3.94 can be taken common out of these cash flows. And we can look at these as discount factors. So if I take 3.94 common, I just multiply them with the total of these discount factors. And then we just need to discount that 100 backwards for 4 period. So multiplied with the last discount factor. All right, let's see if we can do this together. Let's get all the discount factors first. The first discount factor is going to be 1.04. All of you, even if you got the answer right, do this with me. 1.04 y raised to x 0.3 equal to. I told you we are using annual compounding, so we'll have to adjust the exponent. 1.04 ÷ 2x 0.3 equal to. Now take an inverse of this number. So it should be 0.98 something, STO1. That's your first discount factor. How did I get it? So I use simply 1 divided by 1.04 ÷ 0.3. In the same fashion, let's do the next one. 1.05 ÷ 2x 1.3 equal to inverse, because we need a discount factor, not a compounding factor. How much is that? 0.9385, STO2. 1.06 ÷ 2x 2.3 equal to inverse. How much? 0.87, STO3. 1.07 ÷ 2x 3.3 equal to inverse. 0.79, STO4. So these are your four discount factors. With them, we can use a faster method to value the bond using this formula. So let's do it together. 3.94 multiplied with bracket open RCL1 plus RCL2 plus RCL3 plus RCL4 bracket close equal to, that's present value of your four coupons, plus bracket open, 100 into RCL4 bracket close equal to, how much is that? 94.17. But this 94.17 we will have to convert. We will convert in which currency? Australian dollars. And we will convert at the exchange rate at initiation or exchange rate today? Exchange rate today, because today we are doing the valuation today itself. So today exchange rate is 1.2105. So do you want me to multiply or divide? Of course, multiply. So 94.17 multiplied with 1.2105. How much is that? 109.15. 114. That's it. Okay, so 114 million, but now in which currency? Australian dollars. This was US dollars. Correct? So that US dollar we've converted to Australian dollars. Why? Because we want answer in Australian dollars in this instance. Now, is this your asset or liability? Liability. So I told you what you do is, at this step itself, you make it negative and you store it in the 8th memory slot so that we don't have to worry about asset or liability in the final stage. Make this number negative and store it in the 8th memory slot. Is it okay? So first part of your calculation is done. Let's do the second part of the calculation, which is valuation of Australian dollar fixed coupon bond. Now tell me, is this asset or liability? Now this is your asset. So again, we build a timeline. So this is time 0, time 1, time 2, time 3, time 4. What is the face value of this bond? A lot of people would end up taking 100 here. And if you do that, you're making a mistake. Because we know that notional principal for Australian dollar was how much? 140, right? We convert. So face value here is 140 million Australian dollars. And what's the coupon rate? It's the fixed rate on that leg of the swap. So 7.87. So let's do face value into coupon rate. Tell me what is the coupon amount? 11.02. Okay, so 11.02. All of this is millions Australian dollars. And in year 4, what other cash flow will get? 140. And today we are where? 0.7, right? So this is 0.7, this is today. Now, the first cash flow you need to discount backwards for how many days? 0.3 years. Do we have a 0.3-year discount rate available in Australian currency? Yes. The second one you need to discount for 1.3. Is it available? Yes. So this time we'll directly use the shortcut. What is the shortcut? 11.02, which is the coupon amount, multiplied with revised discount factors in Australian currencies. Z1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. Plus face value, how much? 140 into Z4. Make sense to you? So let me plot the Australian dollar rates here. 4, 4.2, 4.7, 5.1. 4, 4.2, 4.7, and 5.1. Let's calculate the discount factors together. Do this with me. 1.04. You tell me, what should be exponent here? 0.3, because we're just discounting for 0.3 years. So raised to 0.3 equal to. But this is more than one, so this is which factor? Compounding factor, right? If you want to take a number forward, you do it this way. But we need to discount, so what are you going to do? Inverse. Take an inverse, store it in first memory slot. How much is this? 0.98. Let's do the next one. 1.042, varies to x, 1.3 equal to inverse. How much? 0.94 STO2. 1.047, varies to x, 2.3 equal to. And then take an inverse. Please make sure you hit equal to button first and then inverse. Equal to inverse. How much? 0.89. And the last one, 1.051, virus to x, 3.3, equal to inverse. 0.84 STO4. Now let's do the valuation. 11.02 multiplied with bracket open RCL 1 plus RCL 2 plus RCL 3 plus RCL 4 bracket close equal to. This is your present value of all the four coupons plus bracket open plus bracket open 140 into RCL 4 140 into RCL 4 bracket close equal to. Tell me how much? 159.41 in Australian dollars in millions. Is this your asset or liability? Asset. So let this number remain negative. Put this in the ninth memory slot. So your liability negative 8, your asset positive 9. So now we don't have to worry. Now what we do in the final step is simply RCL 8 plus RCL 9. And that's going to be your final value of the swap. How much? 45.4. Okay, 1. In which currency? In Australian dollars. Had the question asked to get you an answer, if the question asked you to determine an answer in US dollar, how would you do it differently? You will keep the US dollar valuation as it is. You will take the Australian dollar bond valuation, convert that to US dollars, and then take a difference. The only thing you need to remember is you need to ensure that when you take the difference of the two bonds, they are in the same currency. Otherwise, the comparison is not meaningful. Easy? Do you want to practice similar one? Okay, let's do one then. I am still not bringing in quarterly or semi-annual payments because then that becomes a little complex with all the LIBORs floating around. We'll keep it annual compounding. We'll keep it simple, at least for first couple of questions. So let's take euro. Let's take British pounds, GBPs. let us set exchange rate as 1.1025 euros for a British pound. Let's keep the notional principle as £200 million. Do you want a slightly different variety? So let's keep euro fixed, but let's keep the GBP side floating just for fun. So I'm going to give you the interest rate structure at inception. We'll keep it for 3 years, so we'll not have to do much calculations. Year 1, 2, 3. Year 1, 2, 3. Let's say 2.2%. I'm just making up randomly. 2.8%, 3.5%. Let's say 1.8%, 2.1%, 2.2%. Question number 1. Price the swap, which is simple, you should be able to handle it. Then in the second part of the question, we have to do valuation. Okay, so let's say after 0.4 years, the term structure looks like this, euro, 0.6, 1.6, 2.6. 2.8, 3.5, 4.1 GBP, 0.6, 1.6, 2.6, 1.3, 1.4, 1.45%. Exchange rate here, €1.0205 for British pounds. You have to do valuation from someone who is going to receive GBP, and he's going to receive euros and pay GBP. Let's get the answer in euros. This question is exactly like the last one. The only thing that changes is one of the bond is going to be a floating coupon bond. So if you improvise a little bit, you should be able to handle it. You have all the information you need to solve this. Cash flows are paid every year. Yes, is it done? Guys, are we done? Let me know if you're ready. If you're ready, I'm ready. 2.68 loss. Okay. What's your answer? 7.12 profit. Interesting. 2.16, 7.12. Sorry, how much? 7.12 loss. I'm sure you've done the fixed part easily. You're just wondering about the floating part, right? And you would be surprised, floating part is really easy. There's nothing in floating part. There's just one small trick, you get that, floating part is done. Come on, give me your answers. How much? 22.89 loss. That's a big loss. Want to do it together? Okay. All right, I'm solving this. Be with me on this one. After this question, I'll give you a break. So first we'll value the euro currency bond. Is it fixed or floating? Fixed. So this has a fixed coupon and you're receiving euro. So is that going to be your asset or liability? That's going to be your asset. And since we want answer in euro, we will not be required to convert this one. So let's build a nice timeline here. Time 0, 1, 2, 3. Today we are at 0.4 years. So we are somewhere here. This is time 0.4. This is today. Now, what is the face value of this bond? So we know that GBP face value was 200 million. GBP, but we need to convert that to euros and exchange rate was 1.1025. Should I multiply or divide? Multiply. So multiplied with 1.1025. Now if there's anyone sitting here who generally gets confused with when to multiply, when to divide. You can use this school level logic. GBP needs to be eliminated, so your answer comes in euro. So how much is this going to be? Two, Chaitanya, just you. How much? 220. 220.5. That's it. Million. Which currencies? Euro. Now, what is the coupon rate? So to find out the coupon rate, you'll have to price this part. Now, this I'm going to assume that you're fairly comfortable with. 1 minus Z3 divided by Z1 plus 2 plus 3. So tell me, what is the price here? 3.46%. So now, your coupon is going to be, so coupon rate is 3.46%. So your coupon amount is going to be 220.5 multiplied with 3.46%. How much is that? 7.64. That's it. Okay. So 7.64. So here are my cash flows. 7.64. Anything else? Notional principal. How much? 220.5. The first cash flow you want to discount for how many days? 0.6 years. Do you have a 0.6 year rate? 2.8%. Then next one would be 1.6. Do we have the rate? And 2.6. Do we have the rate? Yes. So now we will use a shortcut. I'm guessing this part you've done well, so I'm going to save time. You calculate the discount factors, you use a shortcut, which is coupon multiplied by total of discount factors plus face value into the last discount factor. There's a good probability, especially on the CFA level 2 exams, not on FRM. Level 2 exams, they will provide you the discount factors. You'll not be required to calculate. They might provide you the total of discount factors as well. In a case study format, they'll provide you a table with all the information. So what you need to do is take coupon, multiply with the total of discount factors, face value, multiply with the last discount factor, job done. Right, so it significantly reduces the computation that you need. On FRM, if this shows up, most probably you'll have to do the entire set of calculations by yourself. So now, once you do this entire set, what valuation do you get? How much? 220.27 million euros. All of us agree on this? Okay. Asset or liability? Asset. Should this be positive or negative? Positive. 8th memory slot. So we'll go sequential. First 8, then 9. Got it? Let's do the next one now. This is going to be fun. This is valuation of GBP floating coupon bond. Is this your asset or liability? This is your liability. Again, we'll build a timeline. Time 0. Time 1. It's not to scale. Time 3. Now, today we are here. We are at time 0.4. This is today. We want to value a floating coupon bond. The logic is same. Value of a floating coupon bond is also present value of future cash flow. We need to figure out what would be cash flow of year 1, year 2, year 3. For that, we need the spot rates, right? The reference rate. So let me plot the reference rate. Time 0, 1, 2, 3. I need all 1 year rates. So at time 0 in GBP, do you have 1 year rate? How much? 1.8%. Do you have 1 year rate at time 1? No, you don't. A 1 year rate at time 1, you would understand or you would know when you reach at time 1. Have we reached at time 1 today? No. So how can you know a future rate? You can guess by calculating a forward rate. That you can do, but You do not know exactly how much that rate is going to be. How can you know what is going to be an interest rate 0.6 years from now? Correct? We don't know this, we don't know this, we don't know this, but we don't care. Because if I know this rate, I can figure out what would be cash flow here, which means the coupon here is going to be 1.8%. You already knew it. The coupon on the floating side is basically 1 year rate on previous reset. And since the valuation was happening between 0 and 1, I was not required you to give you any other rate. You just had to figure out what was 1 year rate at inception. That's it. Job done. Are you following this? And do we know that market value of a floating coupon bond on reset is equal to its face value? What is the face value here? 200 million. Do I need to know the cash flow at year two? No, because this market value takes present value of all future cash flow. So I don't have to worry about this. So I just have one cash flow here, which is 200 market value, also the face value and the coupon of 1.8%, which is going to be how much? 3.6, right? So 200 into 1.8% is 3.6. So what is my total cash flow? 203.6. And this 203.6, I need to discount for how many years? 0.6 years. Do we have 0.6 rate available? Yes, what is that? 1.3%. So value of your bond is going to be 203.6 divided by 1.013 raised to 0.6. We're discounting backwards for 0.6 periods. So what's your valuation here? 202.02. This is in which currency? GBP. But we need answer in which currency? Euros. So once you have this 202.02 in GBP, we need to convert this in euros. And conversion at which rate? The current rate. So current rate is 1.0205. And now you want to convert GBP to euro. So what are you going to do? Multiply or divide? So do it and tell me how much valuation do you get in euros? 197. You'll have to multiply this number and 202.02, do this with me, into 1.0205. 206.16. Positive or negative? Negative. Why? It's a liability. Put this in the ninth memory slot. And then the final step, which is RCL 8 plus RCL 9 equal to 14.11. Which currency? Euros. Positive or negative? Positive. Are you sure? Okay. So that's your value of the swap. How many of you got this right before me? Okay. All right. You can ask questions. So let's start with Gagan. Sorry, speak slowly and a little louder. Guys, please, no noise. Okay, I got the question. The question he asked is, why did we not find out the... Can we please cut down that? Is it coming from your shoes? No? Someone else kept their mobile phone in your bag. It's fine, take your time. Okay, let's not pressurize her. Let's just stare at her. Take your time, no problem. जिसने फोन किया उसको फोन उठा के गाली बको पहले. ओके सो आई एम सॉरी, आई विल रिपीट गगन्स क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन वाज व्हाई डिड वी नॉट प्राइस द जीबीपी साइट, व्हाई डिड यू नॉट यूज दैट 1-Z3, बिकॉज द होल आर्ग्यूमेंट इज वी हैव टू कीप बोथ द वैल्यू बोथ द साइड्स एट पार. सो ऑन द यूरो साइड इट वॉज फिक्स्ड. So we ensured it's par. On the GBP side, it's floating. It's automatically par. Correct? Because we know that on every reset date, floating side is going to trade at par. So we don't have to do that. Did you enjoy? Let's do a quick poll. Easy, medium, difficult. You know what? Let's cut the medium part. I know that's... Easy or difficult, compulsory for everyone. How many of you think it's easy, including Bangalore? Raise your hand. People who think it's easy. These are all the overconfident people. All right, that's good enough. Do you want to practice more or? You can do oral technique, but here it's very complicated. Why? Because first you have to value the bond. See, like, guys, you can try solving this. In this case, it's going to be very tough. I'll tell you why. First, you have to value the bond by estimating the new YTM. Then you have to load up the accrued interest. Then you have to factor in the currency movement. And then you have to figure out what the final answer is going to be. If they are moving in the same direction, it becomes easier. If in one side, value of bond is decreasing, but value of currency is increasing, then the whole thing gets very complicated. Then we can make a guess. Very similar to original one. Then you can try to do this orally. All right, take your break. You deserve one. You get 20 minutes. Then we'll start again. I'm guessing currency swap you're comfortable with. And currency swap now is done.